Hey, welcome to the show. Feeling good with Duddy. That's me. Let's go. Episode 100 of Feelin Good With Duddy, the show that points at the world, has a laugh, points in the mirror, has a laugh. That's us, guys. Fairest of the fair, bravest of them all. You know us. It's episode 100. I'm Jake B., the co-host of this show. Let me introduce you to the host, the man, the guy who started this show. Guitar player, singer of the Dirty Heads, fresh off the Rome and Duddy tour. Here he is, guys. Duddy B. Yeah,
what is happening? Episode 100. Cannot believe it. Can't believe we're here. But yeah, fresh off the Rome and Duddy tour.
That was it?
Awesome. Man,
I
played some shows. We played some concerts, Jake. We got to get out there and it felt so good to get out there with the fans and just play some live music again. And not only that, it just felt really good to be on a bus with my buddies, traveling around, playing some music. God, there's nothing better. I missed that. And it looks like me and Rome are going to be actually touring with each other all summer long, Jake.
That's crazy. Tell everybody what's going on.
But not with the Rome and Duddy project. That's right. It looks like the Dirty Heads and Sublime with Rome will be doing a summer tour, co-headline summer tour all summer long. If you heard that, that's right. That's my nephew. That is Jake's son, Rocky. Yes. He's in the house today.
He could not miss episode 100. Actually, I could not get a babysitter for today, so my son is in the house, and he's trying to become part of the show.
Look it, guys. We got a really fun show for you. I'm going to try and walk you through this really quick while Jake takes care of Rocky. We have an awesome show for you. This is episode 100. We wanted to try to do something really special for you guys, so we have something special, and we planned this last night. We had absolutely zero planned. We've been telling you guys that we're going to do something special, but we had nothing planned. And last night I started hitting up all my friends and seeing what we can do. And we have a great episode planned. I actually have, I believe, 5 acts now. And who knows, some more might even come in. We have Pacific Dub coming in. We've got Bikini Trill. We've got Cydeways coming back in. Possibly Denim, not confirmed yet, but we're hoping he comes in. And the man himself, Cheez, is he's even going to stop by and say what's up. So it's going to be an awesome episode. I can't believe we're at episode 100. Jake's running around. Rocky's going crazy. I'm going to get out of here right now and just jump into it. Here we go. I'm going to start you guys off with good friends. I've been playing shows with these guys. I mean, I don't even know. Turtle, how long we've been playing shows with Packed Up? 7 years?
7 years.
Seven? 11. Holy moly. 11 years I've known these guys, been playing shows with them. We've toured together, played many festivals. Awesome group, awesome people. So I'm just going to get into it. Let's start off with Pacific Dub. All right. And we are here again with Colton from Pack Dub, but now we also have Dave and Hunter.
What's up?
Very stoked to have these guys here. As you guys heard before, episode 100, we had absolutely nothing planned about 12 hours ago.
Yeah.
So I sent some calls out to some of my buddies and see who can make it. And of course, Pacific Dub came. And not only are they going to talk with us right now, but they're going to also perform some songs for us here in a second. So thank you guys for coming.
Absolutely.
Appreciate it, man.
Yeah, dude.
This is awesome.
This is cool, man. We've been saying it before. We can't really say it now because things are opening up, but like, this is the only open venue in Southern California and I get to have all my buddies come and perform for me. So this is so freaking awesome. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you.
Yeah.
It's going to be exciting. It's cool that like with these new singles that we just put out, that this will kind of be like our first run, like getting to really like play something, you know, like this is the venue.
Well, I'm stoked. And Colton was telling me earlier that because he came, what was that, 3-4 weeks ago, a month ago or so?
February.
Yeah, I was probably way off on the date, but he came and he performed Million Pieces, and that was the first time that he had performed that. And now I also got to hear these next two for the first time as well.
Exclusive.
So we're going to keep that going for now on. Turtle, you hear that? Does anyone call you Turtle anymore?
Yes.
Oh, okay, that's funny.
Always.
Dude, I'm that guy that will, if you had a nickname in third grade, I'm still calling you that.
Oh, you have to.
And I have this buddy, his name is Scott, but I call him Snacky because in back in the day, we called him Snack Bar because every time we'd go to like the high school football games or whatever, I swear every 10 minutes, he'd be like, anyone, I'm going to Snack Bar. So we started calling him Snack Bar. I haven't hung out with him much as I've gotten older. I see him once every 5, 6, 7 years, you know, and I golfed with him not too long ago with him and like a couple of of his buddies that like, and the whole time I'm like, what's up, Snacky, Snacky, Snacky. And I'm like, halfway through, I'm like, does anyone even call you that anymore? He's like, no, no one calls me that.
I'd love to think you're out golfing, dude. And he's like, snacks? Anyone snacks? Right? Like, you're still running that, you know? Anyone?
I'm running the clubhouse. Everybody want
it? Yeah. Dude, that actually made me think of a funny segment I wanted to start, and I haven't started it. So we're going to start it today.
Yes.
Nice.
Do any of you guys have a funny nickname that you've had at some point in your life that you got for a funny reason?
Not for a funny reason, but because my last name is Porter, I got Porta Potty a lot.
That's pretty tough.
It was all right. Oh, yeah. Or Harry Potter, because my initials were HP.
Okay.
So that was like a consistent third grade jab.
Porta Potty is a good name. And that's not like when you're out with, and that's when you have a nickname, like your buddies, like that becomes your name. So even if it's a crappy name, it's not crap. Like Porta Potty, that just becomes your name.
Yeah.
But when you're out at the bar with some, trying to hit on some chicks, and your buddies are like, yo, Porta Potty. You're like,
you're talking to Porta Potty?
Not now, guys.
Yeah. Oh, goodness, dude.
That's good. But speaking of Porta Potty, you told me earlier, Dave, that you have a shit your pants story. So let's just get into it.
Do I? That's why you even get into a band, isn't it? So that you could finally go on to tell your shit your pants story.
Yeah, dude,
I think I was like, it had to have been seventh grade, like eighth grade, and so I had this route where you go to school, but I'd ride my bike,
and that's a time in your life where you don't want to embarrass yourself.
No way. This is like, you know, you don't want to be the shit your pants kid.
No, you don't.
You know what I'm saying?
No, they'll start calling you Porta Potty or something.
Yeah. That'd be really terrible.
Man, I'm riding my bike home, and this is a good little jaunt. Like, I want to say it's maybe like a 3 mile ride to and from, right? So it's like after school. I don't even know what. Actually, I do know what caused this. Middle school food in general.
Oh my god!
I probably ate like a Red Baron pizza and chicken nuggets, and my stomach was just like, "You're gonna shit your pants today, dude." Like, this is going to happen. So riding the bike in like the Huntington Beach wetlands, you got to cruise up and down some hills.
Oh yeah.
So now I'm like chugging along. Oof. You're like off the seat. Like chugging along on your bike, right? And then just there it goes, right? Like just there it goes, boom, hits. Oh. But the thing is you're like with your crew that you like ride home with, right? So I've got like three of my buddies with me, and I'm in my head, I'm like, I fully, like, we're not talking like, like farted.
Like,
and
like it's bad.
We're talking like full shit your pants, dude.
Ooh.
Like you have full on done this.
So is this why they call it the wetlands?
It's cursed, dude. Okay. It's cursed. So to like wrap this up, I'm like, okay, well, I clearly have shit in my pants.
Yeah.
And there's not like a lot I can do. Now, looking back in hindsight as an adult, would have been like, hey guys, like shit my pants. Like, let me hit a bush right quick. I got to at least like get rid of everything. But no, like pride, seventh grade pride. Right. And like, you can't be the shit your pants kid. So I keep trucking. Like, I'm just trucking with load. You know what I'm saying?
Trucking with load.
So here's where it really just goes downhill here though. This is where it goes downhill, boys. Okay, getting halfway, and buddy's like, hey, dudes, my mom's down to like pick us up.
Oh, no.
Because she's got the big mom Suburban,
and we
put our bikes, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, you know, blah, blah. And like, again, as an adult, be like, insist, like, no, I'll ride home.
All right.
But no, like, they were like, come on, we're good, blah, blah, blah. So I get in the car with the shitty pants.
No.
With the shitty pants, dude. And like, I remember clearly, like, it might have been like the buddy or the buddy's mom, but someone just being like, are you okay? Because clearly you smell like human shit. And like, what's going on here? And then it was like, I had to like fess up and like tell the entire car, including the mom now. Mm-hmm. She was involved. And I was like, yeah, can we pull? And we pulled over and like, I hit like a CVS, or it might have been called like Save-On back then or something like that.
Oh, they had to change their name after that day.
They were finding way too many like dirty shit riddled boxers back there. So dude.
Can't you just pull off in the wetlands and just like go behind a bush?
That's what I was saying. Like, if as an adult, any sound minded human being.
But you gotta stay with the group, or you get left behind.
And I'm worried that like I'm gonna have to tell my buddies, like, hey, I shit my pants, and I'll never live it down. I thought I was gonna ride home with shame, with just a pant load of shame. And I'd be done. And no one would ever know. And of course, now they all knew. The mom knew. No nicknames, though.
Wow.
That's when you know you have a solid crew.
Wow.
That is a solid crew of friends.
Okay.
Never spoke of it again.
Wow. Until this day.
Or maybe they did speak of it like crazy. And that's always been my thing, is everyone knew me as the shit his pants kids, but I never knew.
Does it happen to you often when you walk into a room with them and everyone goes,
exactly.
Yep.
Like at parties, people would point like, that's the guy.
He's
hey, Dave, over here.
And you'd be like, yeah, I'm in the band, right? And they're like, oh, he's in a band. No, we're talking about the pants thing.
Goodness.
Oh, wow.
So thanks for letting me share that. I hope all the Pacific Dove fans out there.
That is freaking awesome. Love to hear it. Love to hear it.
Oh, goodness.
And you guys know how we're doing now, too, for all the listeners. You could send in your own shit your pants stories, and if they're good enough, we'll play it on the show. Luke, what's the email they send it to? It's super tough. It's feelinggoodwithduddy@gmail.com. Send your shit your pants stories there. And
I'll
be shit your pants.
Hey, Luke, will you plug this in really quick? It says it's about to die.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir. What's up?
I was just waiting for you to be like, all right, everyone out there, like, just send in your shitty pants at this P.O. box. Show us proof you your pants.
Dude, check me out. Yeah, I got shit your pants on eBay. Yeah, so many different kinds.
Send it in.
Your favorite artists. All your favorite fartists. Oh, you get it?
Nice.
Oh, God damn it. That was really bad. felt bad. So let's get into something that feels good. I'm not going to hold you guys too long. And we got Bikini Trill setting up behind us. They're going to be performing some songs for us as well today, but I just want to know from you guys, what is one positive thing that you think came out of this whole lockdown and everything that might not have happened if the lockdown never came about?
I was just gonna say that. Yeah, like the new singles and the album and all that, like I think that it just put us in like the right place, like not only physically but mentally.
Yep.
Right, where it was like we were ready to like write these new songs, put them out. It gave, like, I guess you could say it forced everyone into this like little lull and break.
Yep.
So I was like, okay, like let's just focus in and like, let's get in the studio. Let's write these songs. Like, let's get them ready. And I feel like now with that, like pre-planning, it's all slowly now coming around where it's like, all right, these songs are coming out. Three new singles, like just come out. We have new singles also coming out soon.
Awesome.
And so like everything's slowly coming around, like venues or festivals, hopefully will start getting going.
It seems like it.
So I just think like that mentality we had where it was like, okay, like it's definitely a hard place for all musicians right now, but like, let's at least like stay busy and keep working, be ready.
Yep.
Right. And now here we are, you know?
Yeah. So I love it.
Yeah. That was what took it. That's what we needed.
Yeah. I think that's a blessing of being around creatively minded people and being creatively minded. Like the rest of society was shut in and bored, but we were all like, okay, great. Let's write a lot of
music. Let's make something.
Yeah. We have so much time now, and this is like
kind of
a blessing in disguise in a way. So
absolutely, man.
Not to minimize it, you know, there was,
this thing, not to minimize like what happened, cause it was rough for a lot of people obviously, but there was like a little bit of a gift of time.
Yeah.
The time that you spend every day just being like, I have to do this, I have to be here, I have to work. And now you don't have to do those things. And as shitty as it may be in the moment, when you reflect on it later, it's like, oh, cool. I could slow down. My stress level went down a little bit. My heart rate
went
down.
Big time, dude. I agree. Yeah, big time.
Well, I'm just going to say one more thing and then I'm going to let you guys get to it. But they're going to perform some songs for us right now. And these are some of the new songs you guys are talking about, right?
Yeah.
So I'm super excited to hear these. Why don't you guys just give me a quick little rundown of these two songs you're going to play for us, and then we'll get right into it.
Well, these are the two new singles that we just put out. And today we're going to be performing I Got You and Until I Get Home. So
On. Well, you guys heard it here. Stoked. Thanks again, Pacific Dove. You guys, thanks for stopping by, and let's hear some music.
Awesome. Oh, yeah. Appreciate it.
On.
Thank you.
For the afternoon, warm wind blowing through the trees. Can you stay forever here with me? Close your eyes, forget about all responsibilities. Lost in the moment, we got everything that we could do. Even if it's only for a second. Even if it's only for a second. I got you. And you know that you will always have me too. Baby, at the end of the day, there's just no other way around it. I've got you. and you know that you will always have me too. Baby, at the end of the day, there's just no other way around it. Sometimes we get caught up stressing about the little things. You don't have to worry, let me put your mind at ease when you put your hand in mine. Girl, you got my heart feeling just right. Come down to these moments when it's just the two of us. Helps me to slow time down when everything feels like a rush. Even if it's only for a second, even if it's only for a second, I've got you. And you know that you will always have me too. Baby, at the end of the day, there's just no other way around it. I've got you, and you know that you will always have me too. Baby, at the end of the day, there's just no other way around it. All I need you love right now. Won't you give it to me? Won't you give it to me? We don't need to wait around. When it's just you and me, when it's just you and me, all I need your love right now. Won't you give it to me? Won't you give it to me? We don't need to wait around. When it's just you and me, when it's just you and me, I've got you, and you know that you will always have me too. Baby, at the end of the day, there's just no other way around it. I've got you, and you know that you will always have me too. Baby, at the end of the day, there's just no other way around it. Driving down a long dark road, trying to find my way back. Moonlight to guide the way. You've been holding it down, been used to this life since way back. Wouldn't trade it for anything. Don't know how I do this every time, but you know I won't be gone too long, and I can't do this on my own. Do know I'm not stopping this car until I get home, and I know I can't count on you to never let go. No matter how long it takes, you know that I'm on my way. You know I'm not stopping this car until I get home. Whoa, 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 whoa. It gets rough, just need a little love to get through. We take it day to day. I've been gone for too long, just trying to find my way back to you. Promise I won't be late. Don't know how I do this every time, but you know I won't be gone too long, and I can't do this on my get home. And I know I can't count on you to never let go. No matter how long it takes, you know that I'm on my way. You know I'm not stopping this car until I get home. Whoa. Too long, and I can't do this on my own. You know I'm not stopping this car until I get home. And I know I can't count on you to never let go. No matter how long it takes, you know that I'm on my until I get home. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Ooh. All right, we're back. After that amazing performance from Pacific Dub, I got my good friends here, Bikini Trill. How you guys doing?
Amazing.
So good.
Thank you so much for having us.
What a deal.
Good to see you again, man.
Yep. So I've had Roach on and Lauren and Tony before. If you see a new face, we've got Daniel here.
This is Daniel.
New addition.
Daniel Gallardo.
Daniel drummer.
In the flesh.
Yeah. Sir. Right on. So how you guys been? What have you guys been doing?
Man, chilling.
We haven't seen you since post-COVID when we did the last show. It's just like good to be back here. Mm-hmm. Feels like things are getting back to normal.
We've got a spot in K-Town.
Yeah, we've been at K-Town almost every day.
Built a studio.
Working. We built a little studio out there. It's crazy. There's a bunch of good food around.
Bikini Trill headquarters.
Amazing.
Yeah, Bikini Trill headquarters.
That's
been
awesome.
Going crazy. We've been getting really high over there too.
So. No way. I don't believe it.
No.
No way.
You wouldn't believe how high we're getting over there.
Oh my God.
Speaking of high, let me just hit something.
Yeah, you go for it right there.
Moms, now's the time to turn this off.
Well, if they're watching the show.
Let me ask you
something, though. Everybody's talking about this one thing. I want to know about it. Are you into crypto?
I'm actually into crypto,
Okay. I hope everybody here is into crypto, okay?
So right now, there's 50-50 of people listening right now. There's 50% that are going, oh, yeah, me too. Exactly. And the other 50% are going, shut the fuck up.
Exactly. Okay, to those people,
we're
going
to have to start over.
Wake the fuck up. What are you in, Doge?
Oh, man, my portfolio is large, my friend.
Hell yeah.
Yes, I do have some Doge. I got some Doge. I've got a bunch of stuff. I am not going to go into that right now.
Roach got excited on the drive over here.
I got excited on the Doge. Past 2 days, we were up. So I was just like, man, we need to talk about the Doge for a second. The
dog likes to run.
Represent. I'm glad you're in it, though. Yeah. To the moon out there. Hold on for
D-Line. Oh, yeah, man. That is so good, man. So to half of you, I'm very sorry about that last minute of your time.
I accept your apology.
I mean, he's been putting up with us the last like 3 days.
Oh, dude.
All we talk about in practice is crypto now.
Oh, my wife looks at me all the time and just like, are you looking at your crypto again? I was like, yeah. But then I showed her my portfolio. She's like, go work on your crypto. Go. What are you watching TV for?
That's awesome.
Man.
Yeah, no, that's awesome.
No, but it's good to be back here, man. This is badass. For
sure. So you guys made a bunch of new music, I've heard.
Yeah, we actually have been working on a ton of music.
We're going to get to hear some of that a little bit later.
A little bit, yeah.
Hell yeah, we got a new one, sneak peek. It's actually a worldwide exclusive
premiere.
Here.
Debut.
It's not even out yet.
Yeah.
We just got two sneak peeks from Pacific Dub. And now you're telling me that you're going to drop a sneak peek on me as well?
Tis the season.
Wow.
Something about you, Duddy. You know, I don't know.
Mm-hmm. You just have that way.
Maybe it's all the weed I gave you when we toured.
Yeah, I think that's what it is. Yeah. That's honestly what it is.
We actually smoked the biggest joint ever with Duddy on tour.
Yep. That's right.
Off the
record. Was it your birthday?
It could have been.
Yeah.
It could have been. Yeah.
Sure.
I don't know.
It was insane. I don't. Yeah. I think it was like the whole stupid thing about it, I think it was like it is an ounce, like it was a 1 ounce joint, and
That was fucking
every
awesome.
Summer. Somehow we come across one of those.
Yep.
We come across one of those big ones every summer tour, and we, you know, save it till somewhere near the end, which is usually around my birthday. And then that comes out and everyone goes, holy shit.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. That's good times. But, one little thing I'm trying to start here. I did the first one with Pacific Dub, but Roach, nice. That's obviously a nickname of yours.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So do any of you guys have any funny nicknames that you've gotten along the way in your life for a funny purpose? And, you know, tell me why.
Damn. You're giving the mic to me as if I have one.
I feel like you might have one.
Do you have a nickname?
I mean, people will call me Danielson. That's not funny, but that's Danielson. Just like followed me.
Okay.
That's
okay,
as funny okay. as your shit, your pants story.
Yeah. Why?
Well, nope.
It's not that funny of a shit your pants story. Nope. I wish I had a funnier one.
No, yeah.
Oh, what I actually got one. I got one for you, if you don't mind. I don't want to embarrass you, bro. It's you know, the
what is it?
I've known Roach since high school. We go way back. And all right,
what is it? I don't even know what it is.
Oh, I'll let you tell it.
Kids used to rag on me. My real name is Karoche. So it started with Cockroach.
Oh, so that's how the Roach came.
Yeah.
Then it was Cockroach in third grade. You know, then it became Roche, and then Roach, and then...
And then the bullies came out.
Man, some kid in high school changed the yearbook and my name in there, and he put Crotch. And I was like, fuck, bro. I'm forever went down in history with that name.
Oh, Crotch. My God.
I was like, man, this is bullshit.
Fuck that guy, hey, wherever you are.
Guy, yeah.
Hey, fuck that guy.
Fuck you, yearbook. You know
that guy, it's the dumbest joke in the world, but for sure, when that guy did it, oh, he was crazy.
Yeah.
It's kind of hilarious. You know,
that one went down in history, for sure.
He was like, Crotch.
He was a hater, bro. Yeah. He was a hater. I had haters back then.
I didn't even know about that. That's hilarious.
Oh, that's good.
Never told that to anybody. Another exclusive.
Another exclusive.
Worldwide exclusive. So you're feeling good with Duddy.
No nicknames for you guys with all of this
that's
color
bullshit,
and hair
man.
And things
that's
happening.
Bullshit. They're holding
man.
Back.
Man.
Well, you
have
to bust real quick.
That's it.
All right.
LJ, that's
all
that's
good.
It.
Well, let's get, you know, I want to get into this music.
Fuck
you
yeah.
Know,
sure.
It was awesome having you guys here, but before you guys leave, like, and I think it's probably going to be because I know you guys made a bunch of music, but I just want to know, like, what's one thing positive that came out of, like, the whole shutdown that you don't think would have happened if the lockdown and the, you know, whole epidemic never yep. occurred?
You know, honestly, just the appreciation for the downtime, you know, just, like, being able to, like, appreciate the time to just kind of make music, create things that we want to create, and, like, be able to kind of sit with that and marinate with it, you know? Because most of the time, it's, like, just go, 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 constantly moving from one place to the next. So that was kind of a blessing in disguise, a little bit of a silver lining, for sure.
Totally. That's awesome. And I could 100% agree yeah. with that, man, for sure. Anyone else? Or
I mean, personally, it just made me want it all much more now that it's, you know, a realistic thing that it can be gone.
Yep.
So now
yeah,
it's coming
totally.
Back. It's like, let's fucking go.
Dude, that's
let's
great. That's
go
great,
to the moon.
For sure. For sure. Oh, man.
All right, now you're twisting. Yeah.
Full circle.
Yeah. Hold on for dear life.
For me, it was crypto was the positive
yeah.
thing.
Yeah.
Straight
up.
No, but right on, man. So let's get into some music. What songs are you guys going to play for us?
So we're going to play Ghost Town, which is a classic oldie but a goodie. And then we have a brand new song. It's called Giddy Up. So you heard it here first. And we'll be playing that as well.
Right on.
Hell yeah. Thank you, Duddy.
Thanks for having
Dude,
us.
Thank you
Duddy.
Guys so much for stopping by. I appreciate it.
Hell
man.
Yeah. Anytime.
Thank you.
Yeah. Right on. Let's get into it.
Hey, to 100 episodes.
Cheers. Oh my God.
Hell yeah. Oh. That's good.
Oh. So for those of you listening and watching, that was Fernet.
What's the verdict?
You know what? It's not as bad as I remember. I was terrified of it because for some reason in my head, I had that it was absolutely disgusting. And I think I may have tried it a long ass time ago and I didn't have a good experience. Yeah. Is there good and bad Fernet or is it just that?
It's just that. There's like one other kind, but they taste the same.
Okay.
Everyone just puts in the category as Jägermeister, and this is just like way better than Jägermeister.
It's way better than Jäger.
Yeah.
I'll give you that.
Yeah.
Because it's not the thing that sucks so much about Jäger is how like thick and just and sugary.
Sugar,
and,
yeah.
That doesn't have that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
I've heard Fernet described as toothpaste in shot form. Does anyone else get that?
Yeah.
Well, there's the Rumpelmintz is the fucking
snowboard.
So Jared, Jared, that he went through a Rumpelmintz phase, gotcha. And he knew that every single person on Earth absolutely hated it except for him.
So he would, that was his thing. He'd be like, oh, you want a round of shots? And I'd be like, sure. And here comes the round of Rumpelman shots and just bum every single person out. But that's what he was best at.
Let's
making people do shit they didn't want to do. He's like, got it. It's an art. All right. So we, I didn't even announce. We are here now. Welcome. All the boys from Cydeways are here. We're so stoked. I mean, they were just here. What was that? 3 weeks ago?
3 weeks ago, yeah.
3 weeks ago.
Popped our cherry 3 weeks ago, yeah.
We contacted them. We were just making fun of our boy Luke here that works with the show because he constantly comes in here to work wearing a Cherry Poppin' Daddy jacket. Like the one that you have if you know you're a diehard fan. Like it's the one where he bought a separate patch and like... What do you iron it on yourself or whatever people do that do that? It's printed on there. Printed, yeah. Even worse, Luke. Oh, it's not legit is the problem. It's actually disgusting that you walk around with a jacket that says Cherry Poppin' Daddies.
Next week you get a bowling shirt and jacket.
Oh my God, he also
See, that's
okay.
What the people want though. Yeah. The double, the jacket. Well,
as long as you know
shirt.
It's not, it's a band and you weren't just repping it. Just go
oh,
out there and
oh, that's a band?
Pop some cherries. Yeah.
Yeah. I would imagine that you wear your Cherry Poppin' Daddy jacket and you walk around drinking Jaeger. Because you got it, right? That's the drink. Sambuca.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, okay.
Yeah, true.
Sambuca with like a roofie in it.
Yeah. Good alcohol.
God. It's
flaming Sambuca. Flaming. Do you do that? No. We're talking to Luke. He doesn't even have a microphone.
Constantly guess.
This is great podcast.
Yo, get him a microphone, yeah, man.
For everyone listening, good thing he doesn't have a mic, and also even better that the camera's not on him. It's bad. but honestly, man, thank you guys so much for coming back down. Dude, Bikini Trill.
Yeah.
That was awesome.
Out of the great performance.
That sounded freaking
That's
awesome.
That's the first time we've seen a play. Trill, they were fucking killer.
Killed
Super
it.
Awesome. Awesome band.
You know what's funny? I was talking to Bikini Trill just a little earlier, and they were like, you guys are there on Spotify or something. He was telling me that. It comes up as you guys are
related artists.
Related artists. You guys always pop up. Yeah. But they said that you guys have never met anything. So
yeah,
we're bringing people.
Yeah.
Like a Jerry Springer episode.
Yeah. Super cool people. Yeah, awesome. Great music.
And they let me use their drum kit. So thank you.
Yeah, they did.
Appreciate that. Yeah.
We don't come prepared for any show. So no. We ask for, hey, can I use your drum set?
Hey, guys, 6 sec. Can I use your amp?
Yeah.
Yeah, right? Do you mind hanging out for like an extra 40 minutes while I do my thing? And then
you want to be so cool. Do you mind if I give that a shot?
I'll give you a beer, man. Thanks again for having us, Duddy. Appreciate it.
Yeah. Dude, my pleasure. So, I mean, like we said, 3 weeks ago, has anything new or very exciting happened in the last 3 weeks that you'd like to share with anyone?
Well, our record is finally done.
Nice.
We haven't announced it though, so don't tell anyone. But our next single, also we haven't announced, I'm going to just say right now, June 18th.
Nice.
Next single coming out.
For you.
You'll only hear it here because I won't announce it until another couple weeks. So,
well, you guys going to come here and perform it for us?
We would love to.
Oh, dude.
Only as long as there's another bottle of Fernet, we will.
The simulator's going.
In the you know, studio here where we record the podcast, we just put in the full golf setup for the golf simulator where we can smash balls in here all day. Nothing is going to get done in here. That is all we are going to do. But I found out some really, really good news just a second ago. Is that last time they were here, you shared your shit story with us about when you shit your pants.
That
and
is
then
right.
Your girlfriend's
stepmom is a big fan and heard the story.
It's not us.
She skips a song or our songs every time. No, she heard the podcast and left a comment on Instagram saying, oh, next time you visit, I'll make sure to leave a plunger. I'll give you everything you need. Absolutely cringy, just not having it, not happy about it.
The one reason he didn't want to tell a story was because of that reason.
Yeah, I knew she was going to listen to it, and I just fucking blew it.
If you haven't heard the poop story, check out episode 97.
Yeah. It's a nice one.
Unless you're related to Kara Dunskis, then not check it out. Nobody else
in the family tree needs to hear it.
People do not need to hear that information.
Yeah, episode 97, he tells an amazing... shit yourself story. So go back and listen to that one and then you will understand what we're talking about. But okay, so a new thing I'm trying here. At any point in your guys' lives, did you get a nickname that people started calling you for a funny reason?
I was Chubbs. But as a baby, I had really chubby cheeks.
Nice.
My entire family has called me Chubbs till I was like, still to this day.
But, okay.
and people and all their friends are like, why do you call him Chubbs? And like, he just had a really chubby cheeks as a baby.
They're like, that's adorable. That's,
and also Duddy P. I also have been called Duddy P. Duddy quite P. some time. But, No, I'm just kidding.
My last name is Kernahan. It's his Irish name. And so in high school, I used to play baseball and we would get drunk a lot. And so my nickname turned into Kernaholic because we would always get wasted. And so then after a year or two, started couldn't handle it. So it turned into Napaholic because I would get too drunk. And then now, so it's Kernaholic to Napaholic in a quick turn of events. Oh,
and now after everyone hears your story, it's going to be Shitaholic.
So it's getting worse and worse.
It's just going to keep getting worse and worse. Yeah. Right on, man. Well, thank you guys so much again for stopping by. Why don't you just tell us a little bit about these next two songs you're going to jam and get into it.
Yeah.
Yeah. The first one we have is one of our biggest now, one of our favorites that we did with Greaves. It's called Shadows. And the second is a little surprise cover. I think I won't reveal the identity just yet, but it's a surprise cover and it's one of the crowd favorites at our shows. For much sure. Much more than our songs are.
We
wasn't here originally.
Yeah. We do that song almost every show about the. Second to last song just to get the crowd hype because they've been just booing us.
Every
the
other
time.
Song people leave to go to the bathroom and whatever. So that's one they stick around for. That's
but yeah, you'll hear it.
Oh my goodness. Right on. Well, dude, thanks you guys so much for stopping
by. Thank you, man.
Thanks, Dave.
Appreciate it.
Let's listen to some music.
Right on.
Thinking I don't feel alright. Screw loose in my head, I feel so dead until I get it right. You know we coming for it all, we gon' see the light. Until then I'm just in the night. Looking at the sky above, I fly away, better day when I feel some love. You know we coming for it all, we gon' see the light. Until then I'm just in the night. 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 I close my eyes so I can't see. Our world collapse into this idiocracy. So I write, I'm thankful for what I've explored. Now we go down, down, down till we sink to the ocean floor. We run around, head to the ground. I conversate till I don't ever get a sound. But I try, what do you mean? Head to the screen, now we go down, down, down. I just can't take it no more. Until then I'm just in the night. Until then I'm just in the night. Until then I'm just in the night. I got diamond flow, game major with a mind like a minor. No, think deep like a minor though. I'm a dinosaur, been around since the time before. I'm all in my zone. Cloud on my tongue, got a mind of its own. Donnie was out of his element. I was like chill, Walter to shut up and boom. Yeah, right up on a nice wave. I'm staying on point like a night blade. I'm sipping on something that feels like it might have a bit of the essence of nightshade. Ayy, a flicker of light, found what I needed and kept it in sight. You kept on looking behind you, I was in line to send it all into the. You kept on looking behind you, I was in line to send it all into the. Until then I'm just in the night. 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 Until then I'm just in the night.
Yeah. Walking down the street when out the corner of my eye saw a pretty little thing approaching me. She said, I've never seen a man who looks so all alone, and could you use a little company? Now, if you paid the right price, the evening will be nice and you can go and send me on my way. I said, you're such a sweet young thing, the way you do this to yourself. She looked at me and this is what she said. Oh, there ain't no rest for the wicked, and money don't grow on trees. I got bills to pay, I got mouths to feed. There ain't nothing in this world for free. You know I can't slow down, I can't hold back, though you know I wish I could. Oh no, there ain't no rest for the wicked until we close our eyes for good. Time of chimpanzees, I was a monkey. Butane in my brain, so I'm out to cut the junkie with the plastic eyeballs. Spray paint the vegetables, dog food stalls, and the beefcake pantyhose. We'll kill them headlights and put it in neutral. Start car flaming with the loser in the cruise control. Babies in Reno with the vitamin D. Got a couple of couches, sleep on the love seat. Someone keeps saying I'm insane to complain about a shotgun wedding and a stain on my shirt. Well, don't believe everything that you breathe. You get a parking violation and a maggot on your sleeve. So shave your face with some mace in the dark. Saving all your food stamps, burning down the trailer park. Ayo, well fuck it. So open the door, I'm a loser baby, so why don't you kill me? I'm a loser, baby, so why don't you kill me? Sure. Well, cut it.
We had to play one of our favorite covers, this guy's.
All right, another amazing performance from our good friends in Cydeways. I'm going to do a quick sponsor read for you guys, but don't go anywhere. We got two more amazing performances coming up from our own Jake B and the one and only Mr. Cheez. All right, so Koi, CBD, what an amazing product. You know about it. I've said it every episode. They've been with us since the beginning. That means they've been with us for 100 episodes. Koi CBD, we love this product, man. You guys have heard me. I use it every day. I take the drops in the morning. I love the way it makes me feel. I get crazy aches and pains in my hands, in my fingers and everything from playing sports and guitar all my life. But ever since I've been on a steady diet of CBD, I've definitely noticed that it happens a lot less. But even though it happens less, it does still happen. And when it does, they have all these amazing rubs and creams. I put them on my hand. It's one of those things you rub it on. You don't think about it. 20 minutes later, you're like, oh my God, it doesn't hurt anymore. It's amazing. Go to KoiCBD.com, put in code FEELGOOD at checkout, and you will get 15% off your first order. That's right. And also plug-ins keychains. They have an amazing product called the Jack Rack. It's really awesome. It's a replica to a guitar amp head. They have Fender ones, they have Marshall, and it's just a little replica you mount on your wall. It's a keychain holder. It comes with four keychains. They are quarter-inch cables. You put your keys on them. When you get home, you plug in your keys to your amp, and when you got to go somewhere, you know where your keys are. They're in your amp head that's right on your wall. You unplug it, you're on your way. You'll never lose your keys again, and you can get them at pluginskeychains.com. That is with a Z and plural, pluginz.com. And pick yourself up a Jack Rack. Put in code DuddyB at checkout, and you will get 20% off every order you make for the rest of your life. That's right. You heard it here, people. And you know what else you're about to hear? Let's get into our very own. Jake couldn't be here for the rest of the episode. He had to leave and go take care of his son, but he is here now in our studio where he is going to perform a song for us. So let's get to it. I'll see you guys afterwards. Peace.
Mm-hmm.
Yesterday has come and gone. No use looking back, moving on. Proud of almost everything I'd done. The good, the bad, it was fun. But I don't wanna wait till the sun comes up to catch a wave. I don't wanna wait till the waking hour, I'll go insane. I don't wanna wait. I don't wanna wait. An amazing performance from our very own Jake B, my brother. I remember when he showed me that song. It might have been a couple years ago, and I was like, man, I love that song, Jake. That's fire. You should do an entire album of that stuff. And he might be, and we might be working on it right now. And yeah, that's not it, though. We got one more amazing performance from my manager. He was on episode one. He's everyone's favorite, guys. Give it up for Mr. Cheez. Here he comes.
Send it. You can send dead flowers by the mail. Say it with dead flowers on my way. And I won't forget to put roses on your grave. When you're sitting by in your rose pink Cadillac, making that song Kentucky Derby Day. I'll be in my basement room with a needle and a spoon, another girl to take my pain away. Take me down, little Susie, take me down. I know you think you're the queen of the underground. You can send dead flowers every morning. Send dead flowers by the U.S. mail. Say it with dead flowers at my wedding. And I won't forget to put roses on your grave. No, I won't forget to put roses on your grave.
Thank you. That's right, people. Give it up for Cheez. What an amazing dude. From episode 1 to episode 100, I just want to say thank you to everyone for listening. Thank you for all the support. We can't wait to give you guys another 100 amazing episodes. We'll see you guys next time. Love you guys. Peace out.